हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज़ राधिका चौहान, अ स्टूडेंट ऑफ बीए सेकेंड ईयर। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द सेलेंट फीचर ऑफ इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन। वी हैव द बुक ऑफ इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन हियर इन फ्रंट ऑफ अस, विच इज़ अ वेरी थिक बुक। एज वी आर द सिटीजन्स ऑफ इंडिया, वी नीड टू नो अबाउट द सेलेंट फीचर्स ऑफ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन। The Indian Constitution was enacted on 26 November 1949. It took 2 years, 11 months and 18 days to complete the whole book of Indian Constitution, and over 64 lakh rupees was expended. So now let us discuss the salient features of Indian Constitution. At the very first, we have that the Indian Constitution is the lengthiest written constitution. No any constitution of the world is so as lengthy as the Indian Constitution. Originally in 1949, Indian Constitution had a preamble, 395 articles, 22 parts and 8 schedule. But today we have 448 articles, which is divided into 25 parts and 12 schedules. This book of Indian Constitution is so thick because it not only contains the provisions for its government, but also a detailed administrative provisions are also given here. And this has become a very lengthy because of the geographical factors of our country. Because our country is very vast in its size, and also we came through the British rule, which in 1935 passed an act that was the Government of Indian Act of 1935, which was so lengthy. So we take that act in our present constitution, so it has become double in its length. Now the second features of our Indian Constitution is that we have drawn the many provisions of our Indian Constitution from the various sources. Like we have taken the provisions from British Constitution, as we are seeing that the parliamentary form of government we have adopted from the British Constitution. As we were very much familiar with the parliamentary form of governments in the last 200 years, rule of law, legislative procedure and many other things we have taken from British Constitution. From US Constitution we have taken fundamental rights, independence of judiciary, judicial review, impeachment of the president and many other. Like that we have taken so many provisions from the constitution of whole world, like Irish constitution, Canadian constitution, Australian, Weimar constitution of Germany, Soviet Union, and there are four more, Russia, French constitution, South African and Japanese constitution. So we have taken the very important and very good points from good provisions from whole world to make our constitution different less defective than other constitutions. Now next Now the third feature is that our Indian Constitution is the blend of rigidity and flexibility. The Constitution of India is neither rigid nor flexible, but a blend of both. There are some provisions which are amended by special majority. Some provisions require both the special majority and the ratification by half of the total states, and there are some provisions which gets amended by a simple majority only. There are some provisions when are included in the Article 368 does not get amended. Now the fourth feature we have federal system with unitary bias. Our constitution provides two systems, federal system also and unitary system also. But other countries like American, British adopt only a federal system. Either they adopt federal system or unitary system. But we have taken both the features. Sometimes our government becomes federal and sometimes it becomes unitary. Federal, like we have two governments at the center and one government at the state. We have division of powers, we have written constitution, and we have the supremacy of the constitution. These are the features of federal system. And the unitary features like strong center, single constitution, single citizenship, appointment of state governors, emergency provisions, etc. These are the features of unitary bias. So we have both the features, federal as well as unitary. At the time of the emergency we become unitary, and in the normal conditions we remain federal. Now next we have parliamentary form of government. As just now we discussed, because we were under British rule, we from 200 years we were involved in the parliamentary form of government, so we were very much familiar with it. That's why instead of adopting presidential form of government, we adopted parliamentary form of government, because it is a complete, it gives us a complete cooperation and coordination between legislative and executive body. Now the sixth feature we have, the Supreme Court. It is the highest court of appeal in our country. Now any court can pass judgment against the decision of Supreme Court, and it is integrated as well as independent also. It is integrated in the sense that there are high courts below the Supreme Courts for every state, and it is independent in the sense that judges are paid from the consolidated fund of India. There is a prohibition on the discussion on the ground on the conduct of the judges in the legislature. There is a ban on the retirement of the judges, and you cannot condemn the decision of Supreme Court. And we have the separation of judiciary from the executive. So Supreme Court is also one of the very important feature of our Indian Constitution. Now we have fundamental rights. Fundamental rights are certain rights which are given to us by the Constitution of India. These are mentioned in the part 3rd of the Constitution. There are 6 basic fundamental rights mentioned in the Constitution, which we have already studied many times in our smaller classes, so we will not discuss that here. Fundamental rights was taken in the Constitution of India to protect us from the tyranny of executive and from legislature. These are justiciable in nature, that if our fundamental rights are get violated, we can go to the Supreme Court directly. We need not to go to any subordinate courts or high courts. We can directly go to the Supreme Court, and Supreme Court issues a writ against it, which are habeas corpus, mandamus, prohibition, certiorari, and quo warranto. So we can save very much, we can feel very much safe under the fundamental rights. Now the next we have directive principle of state policies. These are the directions which are given from the Constitution to the state governments for making the state welfare, so that they should keep the directives in their mind while formulating the laws. And but the one of the defect, or this would be good also, this cannot be called as defect, that these are non-justiciable. If a state government is not enacting the directive principle of state policies in their laws, we cannot go to any of the court, because it depends upon the financial condition of the state. So that's why it has been made non-justiciable. Now the next we have fundamental duties. With fundamental rights, we have certain fundamental duties also. Fundamental duties, we have like we have to respect our national flag, national anthem, we have to protect the sovereignty of our country, we have to maintain the unity and integrity of our country, we have to promote the feeling of brotherhood, and we have to preserve the rich heritage of our composite culture. But these are the fundamental duties. Now we have a secular state. This is also one of the feature of our constitution, that there is no any particular religion of the state. All the peoples of all the religions live with a unity and friendship in our country, and it is the duty of the country to give respect to all the religions and protect rights of every religion. The concept of secularism is different in the Western world, and our concept of secularism is different. Our concept of secularism tells us that the state, the central government, have to give protection to all the state, while the Western form of secularism tells that state government will not going to give protection to any of the state. Now next we have single citizenship. Though we have central government, we have state government, but we have single citizenship. But it is not the same in USA. USA have dual citizenship. People of USA enjoys the citizenship of the state also, and of the union also. But in India, we are free to move in any of the state. We are free to have a home. We are free to get a job in any of the state. But it is not so in USA. Now another feature is independent bodies. There are around hundreds of bodies of legislature and executive which work independently from them. Like we have election commission, comptroller and auditor general. We have Union Public Service Commission. We have State Public Service Commission and many others. Now the another silent feature is emergency provisions. The Constitution of India provides for three types of emergencies. First is national emergency, which is mentioned in the Article 352. Second type of emergency is state emergency, which is mentioned in Article 356. And financial emergency is mentioned in 368. At that, in the normal condition, our government remain federal, but at the time of emergency it becomes unitary bias. All the power goes to the center. Then we have three-tier system is one of the feature of our constitution, that we have central government, state government, and we have panchayat also, which is also known as rural local government, and we have urban local government also. So it is very to make the administration very much efficient. And at the last, we have a universal adult franchise. Anyone who is 18 years of age can vote to select their representatives to the Lok Sabha and to the state legislative assembly. And earlier the age of voting was 21 years, but then it was reduced to 18 years of age in 1918. 9, and it was a very nice experiment, or it was a very nice step taken by the Indian government because of the increasing population of our country. So we have discussed all the features of the Indian Constitution. I hope you come to know about the salient features of the Constitution, and being a Indian Constitution, we should have a little knowledge about it. So thank you very much.